Hayley Leggs with Total Rock here at Bloodstock 2022 with Lord Ahriman from Dark Funeral. How are you faring in this heat today?
Well, we just arrived, so I haven't really had a chance to feel how I feel about that.
It's been air-conditioned in the luxury.
Yeah, we spent some hours at the hotel. We just arrived this morning and we haven't slept last night. We went straight from Partisan straight to the airport and flew over here,
So you haven't slept at all?
Yeah, we slept a little bit on the hotel this morning. And then we just came here, so.
Are you going to have enough energy?
I mean, for me, it's all right.
Yeah?
I find that energy, don't worry.
Yeah, you've been doing this a long time, yeah. you know what you're doing. Nearly 30 years, right?
Yep.
Wow. So how have things changed for you since the early days, like in terms of, you know, like how it is to tour, what the whole industry is like? What's changed?
Well, everything's changed, of course.
Yeah,
we talked about it earlier. I mean, in the early days, you were traveling in a small van. You took turns because the only place you could lay, you know, stretch yourself was on the floor. So you took turns, you know, lying on the floor in the van and slept 30 minutes and the next one to sleep 30 minutes. And, you know.
Yeah.
But I'm glad I went through the hardcore introduction to this business because that makes me appreciate everything better now. And also I'm, I can handle rough situation better.
Nice, yes, so it was good training for you and now you appreciate everything that does come your way, all the good things.
Yeah, but still, travel, you know, it's whatever level you come to, it's always going to be tough travel, you know, flying early flights and van shuttles back and forth, you know, that's never going to change. Until you have your private jet and shit.
Right, one day, maybe in another 30 years.
Yeah. I won't give up, I'm going to have a fucking private jet.
Well, I noticed you're quite active on social media, so you're keeping up with things like that, always posting pictures of you and your mates in other metal bands. Who are your best friends in the metal scene?
Oh, hard to say. But always, it feels like, you know, always when I meet Cannibal Corpse, it's like his family. We started touring together, and and it feels like we're going back to the roots, and we're going to keep on touring this year and next year together. We're making plans together. It's like, you know, we're going back to the family where we started, basically. And that's, you know, when there's a few bands when you have that connection. You'll know them for 25 or 30 years, and it doesn't matter if you don't see each other in 2-3 years. As soon as you meet, you're like, it's family from first second.
Yeah.
It's always like that. And Cannibal is one of the bands, and there's a few more.
Is it George the singer? What's his name?
Corpse Grinder.
Huh?
Yeah, Corpse Grinder.
Yeah, he's crazy.
He would probably, you can ask him about me.
Yeah, in fact, I think it was here one time. He was so super drunk. Like, one of the other band's tour managers had to get me to, like, separate them because he wouldn't let Sepultura leave. He was like, Derek, stay. He was wasted.
He likes the poker.
Huh?
Yeah, he likes the party.
Yeah, and the same with Cradle of Filth, actually. He wouldn't let them leave at, like, fucking.
Yeah, the two of us have, you know, when we were touring and hanging out in the early days, we were partying a lot together.
Yeah.
I've been sober for almost 15 years, so.
Yeah. So you must like it then, coming to the festivals where you get to catch up with everyone.
Yeah, it's, you know, we're doing 4 festivals this week, and it's been like like a family reunion, you know. Many bands every day that you know and haven't seen in a long time, so just great to catch up with everybody. And there's so many bands I know today, I haven't had time to, we've been texting like, we'll see you later, so I'm going to go and catch up with everybody later. So.
Nice, you partying later? You partying later?
No, as I said, I've been sober for almost 15 years.
So. Have you? Ah, I didn't realize.
I don't drink.
Just personal preference?
Yeah.
Good for you. So you must really notice when people are like super hammered.
I've been one of them myself.
All right, so. And that's why you decided to change your mind?
Yeah, I just came to a point when I feel like enough is enough. I've just tired to feel like shit.
Yeah.
And I like to, I mean, I like to be in control too. And when it's like too much just bullshit happening, you know, when everybody's drunk too, and then you gotta travel, keep everything together, and it's just chaos.
Yeah.
I just came to a point like, I like chaos, but I want control chaos.
Control chaos, yeah, I like it. So, I guess you're like, you know what, I'm fun enough anyway without alcohol.
Yeah, I mean, I feel much better about myself without it. I don't need it, so it doesn't do any good for me. So
no.
You know.
And maybe you'll live longer as well because of it.
We'll see.
Keep going another 30 years, do you think you will?
Well, I mean, I have no plans to stop. I don't know what I would do otherwise, so...
Yeah. What do you think you would have done if you hadn't got into music?
Well, I do different side on side, you know. I design my own jewelries and
I didn't realize
like
you designed that. I saw that you have your own range.
Yeah, I work with people, of course, but yeah, we work on the designs together.
It's so. Some seriously nice jewelry, actually. I was admiring it online. I didn't realize you'd actually put the designs in yourself.
Yeah, I mean, I put high demands on everything I do, and also this. But I'm working on more stuff. But I mean, the first jewelry line was like really exclusive stuff, so it's kind of expensive. This pentagram is one of them.
Oh, how much would that go for?
Well, you can feel it's pure silver.
That is heavy. Wow.
Yeah, so it's
nice.
It's a little bit over 400 euro.
Right,
but
right.
It's
worth
it. Yeah, it's silver, all of it. And you felt the heaviness.
Can I see the rest? Are these all yours?
Well, not all of them. This is prototype. This is not official stuff, but...
Gorgeous. So that's what you'd do then if you were doing music.
This small one is also... This is a special edition just for me, black silver.
The regular one
that's for sale is just pure silver. But I'm going to do like cheaper material so people can afford, you know, everybody can afford it. But I want to do like more really exclusive stuff and, you know, high quality. And then, of course, it's going to be quality stuff, but with cheaper material.
Yeah, yeah.
So I have lots of ideas, so it's going to come more.
Nice, I'm looking forward to seeing it. So your last album came out earlier this year. What's the reception been like to the latest material?
It's been really good. And it's been kind of both sides, which is great. You know, I guess it's... We never had so much hate to a record like we have.
Really?
But at the same time, it seems to be our most successful record too. So, but that's how the scene works.
Yeah.
You know, as soon as you release something that really... reach out to people and really, you know, make people feel it one way or another, then you know that you've done something great.
Yeah. So, why the hate? Why do you think people are hating on it?
I don't know. some people, you know, it's kind of weird. You know, the way this scene works, some people feel like, you know, if a band change, then you suck. If you keep on your roots and keep on your foundation with the music you write, you're still going to suck.
And it's boring.
Yeah, then it's boring. So it's always going to be these people who don't understand that it's your own fucking creativity that counts.
Yeah.
And your complaint doesn't fucking matter. I mean, you can complain as much as I did. I can show you that I did this. I did it from my fucking soul and heart. And it's my creativity.
Yeah.
Not yours.
So go fuck yourself.
Yeah. But it's kind of... I mean, I find it, the whole fucking thing is kind of stupid because... I think people should be... You know, if somebody reach success with whatever they do, fucking be inspired by their fucking dedication, their work and what they have achieved instead of fucking, oh, you're a fucking sellout.
Yeah.
I don't understand that. For me, it's like, I mean, I get inspired when somebody's doing something great. I might not like the record or whatever, but fuck, man, this band fucking, they worked from there and now they are there. I still think they suck, perhaps, but fuck, man.
But they put in the work.
Yeah, they get my fucking respect.
Yeah.
Either way. So, but yeah, I don't know. That's the way the scene always been. We're just one of the bands that always, you know, gonna be in that
position. Great ship, brother.
Yeah, but it's great. I like to be in that position.
Do you ever take off your sunglasses?
Hmm?
Do you ever take off your sunglasses?
sometimes in the dressing room, I tell the guys, no photos.
No one look at me.
No photos until I'm on stage.
Just really ugly eyes or what?
No, I mean, I just like this way.
Fair enough. I should have brought some myself today.
Yeah, I mean, now we got some too. But I don't know. I mean, from the beginning, there was nothing I thought about. And then all the fans have been like, made a thing out of it.
Yeah.
And of course, I like to play along with reactions. You know, they feed me with interesting stuff. So.
Yeah.
So, of course, if that's... I mean, I have people, when they find a photo with me without sunglasses, they can send me a Photoshop photo when they put on the sunglasses. Now it looks... Now it's all right. Or vice versa.
Fixed it.
Yeah, we fixed it for you.
So. Oh, well, thank you for chatting with us. I'm having a lovely time, but I think we're running out of time. And I know you've got more work to do. So, thank you very much.